Hi guys, today I want to talk about a stock I recently added to my portfolio, and that is ticker ACP. It is Asseco Poland, and it is trading in Warsaw Stock Exchange. It's company operating in IT industry. It's developing software. His revenue comes from general business sector, banking and finance, and public institutions. So we are developing software. I think this is trend is quite positive because earnings, as we can see in these three quarters, sale revenues grow up. And these companies have three segments, and we are all growing up. So I pulled data from Morningstar and made quick calculations and want to show why I bought this stock and what I expect from it. So we see we paying dividends, the revenue growing up. So and as free cash flow, but free cash flow reported at Morningstar is not quite accurate. So I made some manual calculations to that, but I explain that later. So for now, I counting what we are returning to shareholders. It is dividends. We paying around 250 million zloty. And I discounted them at 10%. Growth rate for next 10 years is 5%. Even the dividend growth, compound annual growth rate would be 7.5%. So exit multiple, what is trading about now. And this row shows free cash flow. What I calculated, it's around 500 million zloty from reported at Morningstar 1.5 billion. So, and I get intrinsic value per share would be 65 zloty. I added at 68 around, but it doesn't matter because I think this company will continue to grow and deliver around 15% annually return, because I think it's rather cheap, this company. If you look at free cash flow yield, it's around 9%, dividends more than 4%, and this is current share price. And yes, I bought this and I added to my position because I had already Asseco Business Solution. Asseco Business Solution parent company is Asseco Poland. And Asseco Poland have three segments like we saw in earlier spreadsheet. Asseco International segment, Formula System segment, Asseco Poland segment. So for this counting stock, I pulled data too from Morningstar and adjusted calculation for free cash flow. And we see that we are paying dividends 60 million, discounted them, and entered growth rate. First for five years, 7%, because the dividends was growing at 7% annually. And this is free cash flow. And I get intrinsic value per share 42. I bought at 36, current share price 38. So free cash flow yield almost 6%, dividends almost 5%, and low liabilities. Multiple. So these stocks, I would say, both rather cheap, but Asseco Business Solution specializes in enterprise resource planning software. So it's a little bit different niche, but on the law it's IT company, information technology. So now I will show you how I show you the Asseco. This is SAP, is global leader in software development for companies in IT sector, and he pulled the same data and comparing to this Asseco business, and we see we are paying 2 billion euros and discounted, and growth rate added for 10%, because we're growing dividends for 10% annually. So, and for free cash flow, I read the news that this last year we grew especially more than 100%, so it was good year for them, but we for this year expects 4.5 billion in free cash flow. So we see already from the free cash flow yield on market capitalization, it's not yielding 4%, 3.5, dividends only 1%, and current share prices by exit multiple, this is trading today, let's say it's even. But if we change this multiple and these companies, Asseco, start evaluating like SAP company, we easily could see the stock price could double or even more. But for now, leave at this. And with a new world money policy loose, let's say, I think Asseco Business Solution needs only time, and this company will be reevaluated more something like this. And we can expect at least, I think, double from the evaluation in 10 years. Of course, I expect it will be sooner, but we are expecting the cash flows discounted at 10%. So to sum up, I say I expect from Asseco Poland or Business Solution around 15-17% of annually return. So I will show you how I calculated free cash flow from the consolidated financial report for three quarters. So this is the line where we generated in operating activities. It's 1.1 billion. We deduct in CapEx what we financial activities, investing activities, 300 millions, and we deduct net cash provided in financing activities. So to sum up, it's around, we deduct 900 millions from 1.1 billion. Left around 200 billion. If we 200 million, if we divide it by three quarters, it's to sum up, it's around 66 millions. And now multiple by four quarters, we get around free cash flow of 266 million zloty, and we add dividends paid out by the company, and because we are returning the cash we earned to the shareholders, so we can add that, and we get 516 million in free cash flow. So I think we have more cash to pay more dividends, bigger dividends, and we see that free cash flow is around, yield around 9%. Not bad for the growth in this sector, and I think this company is rather cheap comparing to, let's say, world leaders in this sector. So for counting Asseco business solution free cash flow, I used the same method, deducted capex, investing, and added back dividends. And we see that these companies are cheap comparing to leaders. If we add multiple of 60, what we're paying, and comparing to SAP company, this is German company, and like I mentioned, the capitalization around 100 million, billion people, I think, SAP. Yes, we see here. Yeah, 123 billions. So we are leaders, we are stable growing. So Asseco business solution, this is my second buy target, around 30 zloty. Asseco Poland, second buy target, below 58 zloty. And like I mentioned earlier, I expecting this company will return around 15-17% annually yield. So that's it in a short video. If you like it or have some questions, please leave comments. See you in the next one. Bye.